know his freedom, come along with us and join the praise of Jesus. Come to Jesus now, go and live his word rejoicing. One in
But we're not going to advance the cause of the church by being divisive and focused on social issues at the expense of the poor. As a younger Catholic, I know that my friends are walking away from the church in record numbers. They're abandoning the faith because they don't recognize themselves in the leadership of the bishops today. And so we're here as Catholics who love the gospel, who love Matthew 25, who dedicated my life to serving the church, to ask the bishops to refocus on the needs of the poor and vulnerable, and focus on being an inspiration rather than in league with some of the most divisive social issues in our day. So, Bishop, I'm just honored that you came out and said hi to us.
I said I wanted to see what you were for. And really don't have any comments.
Well, can we have your blessing?
You certainly can. I mean, one thing that can't be against is Matthew 25.
That's right, not question. That's the highest. And the amazing thing is, this is what amazes me, is that I believe the greatest con of the 21st century is how religion has been hijacked by secular political interests. That, for example, Matthew 25 is unequivocal. It says, if you don't care for the poor, you are in the eternal fires of hell, essentially.
You can go back a few more centuries for that.
And yet nowhere in any of the Gospels does Jesus talk about contraception